Good evening and welcome to our 777 prayer project. It is day 8 of our 21-day lockdown, and we've been praying for almost 2 weeks now already before the lockdown, and now 8 days in the lockdown. And we just said that we are going to continue to pray as long as we know that there is someone and his name is Jesus. We try to play you that song that says there is Jesus, a beautiful song that we listened to today, and the whole day while we were listening to it, and my wife played it to me, I said we have to just play that in the background. We do apologize for signal problems. The data issues are real all over in South Africa. We can pray for that as well tonight. But we are grateful that you are here, 7 o'clock. Every single night for 7 minutes at a time, we pray together 7 days of the week. And tonight we're going to continue to do that. But that song says Jesus is the Jesus of the valley and he's the Jesus of the mountains. He's the Jesus before lockdown, he's the Jesus in the lockdown, and he will be the same Jesus on the other side of the lockdown. He was the Jesus before the coronavirus came onto this continent, and he is the same Jesus that will help us, that will be with us. And that's why I want to read to you Psalms 33. Verse 4 and then 6 to 9 and then a little bit later, verse 18 to 22. You might ask, but isn't it 7 minutes of prayer? But you'll understand now, every night I just start with some encouragement from God's Word, because we need to pray God's Word. Listen to this. Verse 4 says, for the Word of the Lord holds true, and we can trust everything He does. For the word of the Lord holds true. We don't stand in anything else. We stand upon God's word in this time. Verse 6 says, the Lord merely spoke. The Lord merely spoke and the heavens were created. He breathed the word and all the stars were born. He spoke and he breathed. And then verse 7 says, he assigned the seas and its boundaries and locked the oceans in vast reservoirs. Verse 8 says, let the whole world fear the Lord and let everyone stand in awe of him. May the whole world stand in awe of what God is going to do in this time that we are living in. And then verse 9 says, for when he spoke the word, the world began. It appeared at his command. Proverbs 18 verse 21 says that life and death is in the power of the tongue. And I want us to do that for a few minutes before we're going to pray for South Africa. I want us to stand upon God's word. I want to say to you that every promise is yes and amen. No matter what, no matter what we are facing, no matter what we are going through, every word, every promise in this word is yes and amen. And God says when he spoke, things came into existence. So you and I have the power on our tongues to either speak life or speak death. We are going to tonight speak life over those people who need healing, and we are going to speak death over this virus in the name of Jesus Christ. So I want you to pray with me tonight. Father, thank you that your word says in Psalms that you spoke and things came into existence. You breathed, oh God, you breathed the word and things came under the command of your word and came into existence. So, oh God, we speak into existence tonight by faith, by standing upon your word. We speak into existence life, oh God, life over those people who have been infected by the virus. We speak over their bodies right now in the name of Jesus, and we declare and we command healing over those bodies right now who have been infected by this virus. Lord, thank you that your word says that we can stand upon your word, that we can speak, we can breathe. Just like God, because we've got Christ in us, the hope of glory. We've got this word in our hearts. We've got Christ who is the word inside us. So when you speak, even when you breathe, you are breathing Christ. You are breathing his word. And wherever you are, just agree with me in the name of Jesus. Just speak life right now. Say Jesus. Say the word of God command healing right now. Say it out loud. Say healing in the name of Jesus. We can speak it. We can command it. Just like God spoke into existence this earth, because that same God lives in you and I. That same Jesus lives in you and I. That Holy Spirit that created everything together with the Trinity is the one that empowers us to speak. So speak right now. Even speak over your situation. If there's financial difficulties, speak over it right now. Lord, we speak over people's lives. Whatever need there might be, we speak the word of God over them right now. Father, I want to open up this word as a symbol of breathing God's word over people's lives right now, over their situations right now. Lord, thank you that we can stand upon your word. Then from verse 18 to verse 22, it says, but the Lord watches over those fearing. This is the time to fear God. This is the time in reverence to fear God. Those who rely on His unfailing love. He rescues them from death and keeps them alive in times of famine. Lord, thank you that you rescue us, oh God. Lord, thank you that you rescue us from death tonight in the name of Jesus. I speak to those children of the Most High God, those who live in fear, have a fear of the sickness, oh God. I speak to them right now. Let's rather fear God, the one that can heal, the one that can touch. Oh God, we have a fear. Fear of you, Lord, for you, Lord, not afraid of you, but a reverence for this awesome God that can change everything around. We put our hope, verse 20 says, in the Lord. He is our help and our shield. The word of God is our help and our shield. In Him our hearts rejoice, for we trust in His holy name. Let your unfailing love surround us, Lord, for our hope is in you alone. So tonight, Lord, we bring South Africa before you, Lord. We know that our hope is in nothing else, oh God. We thank you for the government. We thank you for what they are doing. We thank you for our president, oh God. We thank you, Lord, even for churches and people praying and people worshiping 24/7 and people praying 24/7, oh God. We thank you for that because we speak life. But oh God, our hope tonight is in you. You are our God. You are our shield. You are our refuge, oh God. So we come before you right now in the name of Jesus, and we declare healing over South Africa right now. We declare our hope is in you, oh God. Thank you, Lord, that you touch us. Thank you that you stir up in this evening hope, Lord. A shield, oh God, which is you. And Lord, we come against that spirit of death right now. We come against this coronavirus right now in the name of Jesus Christ. And we speak to it and we say, you will die and people will live in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you for your healing hand. Thank you for your power tonight in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. Thank you for joining us for 777. Invite your friends, host the watch party on Facebook. Let us as a church pray together, unite together. If you've got any prayer requests, please don't hesitate to send us an email at 777@kingswayministries.co.za. God bless you. See you tomorrow night. I know it's Saturday night, but don't forget, we are going to continue to pray at 7 o'clock tomorrow night. God bless you.